YouTube's free keyword research tool got a major upgrade, and I have to ask, is this the end of paid YouTube tools? Hey everyone, I'm Andrew Kahn, and I'm a YouTube content creator and educator. I've been on YouTube now for over 10 years, and for 5 of those years, I had the privilege of being TubeBuddy's first employee, which let me help thousands of YouTube creators. If you don't know, TubeBuddy is a browser extension that helps creators grow and optimize their YouTube channels with both free and paid tools. In my time at TubeBuddy, I learned a lot about how YouTube works. It's how I grew TubeBuddy's YouTube channel to over 500,000 subscribers. I've since left TubeBuddy and now help creators on this YouTube channel. Based on my time at TubeBuddy, I think I have a unique perspective of what makes a good keyword research tool. To access YouTube's free tool, head over to YouTube Studio. From here, click on Analytics. Then, click on YouTube's Research tab at the top. This is the new version of the Research tab. Some of you might be familiar with the old version, which looks like this. The new version is a lot more built out. I'll start with the Explore Topics section at the top. I'll type in a topic that's pretty popular for my YouTube channel, phone as a microphone. Here you can see my specific audience activity for this term over the last 28 days, as well as individual terms from the topic such as microphone and mobile phone. Under that, you can see what's being searched on YouTube for a specific topic. And under that, you can see popular videos being watched on YouTube and their thumbnails. If I like this term, which I do, I can save it by clicking this heart icon or save here. I can do the same if I like one of the terms below too. I can also expand these terms or videos by clicking see all here. This section is showing me things people are actively searching for on YouTube. All of these topics I could choose to make a video on. These are given to me by YouTube themselves, all for free. I went from just one idea to multiple ideas, and even if you have a new YouTube channel, you can search what people want to know and make that content for them. This is incredible for creators. It takes out a lot of the guesswork when it comes to making YouTube content. And hey, the fact you can do this on both a computer and your smartphone all for free is amazing, so let's keep going. I want to go ahead and save some of these ideas by clicking on the heart icon, and these are all things I can make videos around. Then I want to focus at the top on content gaps. I'll have what YouTube says about content gaps on screen now. But basically, this means these terms are things people are interested in and searching for, but there isn't a relevant video or the videos about a topic are old, and making a video about this subject could help your YouTube channel get discovered. Each term for content gaps will be different, and while I don't find any of these gaps helpful for my channel, that doesn't mean you won't or I won't either. Now to head back to the beginning of the research tab, you could just hit the tab on the top again, or just hit the back arrows here to see your previous results. If we look under the Explore Topics option, we can see top searches. This section shows the top searches based on your unique audience and the content ideas you've saved over the last 28 days. Some search terms here might even be labeled content gap like I showed you before. If we look under this section, you can also see that this says Shorts content gaps. This shows that this is not just for normal YouTube videos, but this can work for normal YouTube videos, YouTube Shorts, YouTube Livestreams, etc. Shorts content gaps shows where viewers may be looking for more relevant or higher quality shorts. The next section is recent videos related to, which shows videos and topics my specific audience is watching and I can take inspiration from or learn from them. Looking here, one of the videos that someone in my audience is watching is from vidIQ. Speaking of vidIQ, I guess it's time to discuss what this free YouTube feature means to these paid tools. Do keep in mind, from this point on, these are just my opinion. Whether it's vidIQ or TubeBuddy, they both have free versions that have a lot more than just keyword research. However, both of their keyword research options are very limited compared to YouTube's, which isn't. I don't think this research insight tool is necessarily the end, but what I think is important for us as creators to keep in mind is how vidIQ and TubeBuddy responds to YouTube's research tab. If you're unaware, and I'll make sure to link my sources in the description below, paid tools like TubeBuddy and vidIQ, while having access to YouTube's API, which is how they can do the amazing things they do, they don't have exact access to YouTube search results like YouTube's own keyword research tool does. They oftentimes rely on third parties or Google Analytics and social media. Now, that doesn't mean these paid tools are less valuable, it's just something you should know. With YouTube's free keyword research tool, us as creators now have more options than ever when it comes to planning video ideas. The truth is, I want both TubeBuddy, vidIQ, TubeSpanner, any other tool out there to do well because I believe the choice is good for the creator economy. The good thing about the paid tools is the paid aspect causes them to have to innovate. But with YouTube joining, it's going to cause them to innovate even more. I mean, vidIQ offers differences than TubeBuddy. A great example of that is their new coaching program. TubeBuddy has A/B testing, but again, with YouTube getting into the space, YouTube's working on their own free A/B testing. TubeSpanner, in its own right, is doing amazing things that I haven't seen from either vidIQ or TubeBuddy. So all of these tools existing in the space really does push the envelope for YouTube content creators. I still use TubeBuddy every day, and while I've not really used vidIQ as long or as much, I can't help but notice and hear all the good things that people in the creator economy say about them. In that same vein, there are tools like Morning Fame and TubeSpanner, which people say are really good too. And you know, thinking about it, if you'd like me to do a thorough review of all the free and paid YouTube tools out there, let me know in those comments down below. With YouTube's own free research tool entering the mix and getting better, it's only going to push these tools to get better themselves. To answer the question I had at the beginning of this video, I don't think it's the end for paid tools for now. It could definitely be the beginning of the end if these paid tools don't adapt and change to the pace that YouTube is themselves. So whether you're using TubeBuddy, vidIQ, TubeSpanner, Morning Fame, any other of the paid or free tools, and including YouTube's own keyword research feature, we win. And that's amazing for the creator economy. But hey, as I said at the beginning of the section, that's just my opinion and I'd love to hear yours in the comments down below. If you'd like to learn more about YouTube, get real feedback from other creators and grow on YouTube, consider joining my YouTube Creator Discord, which I'll have linked on screen and in the description down below. And remember, if I can use YouTube's own free research tool to come up with video ideas, then you can too.